But you never really earn persona on those. You can only really earn fate. Because you can't complete those beliefs, those kinds of beliefs.
I think I'll go for the one for Bardor's, for your father. Bardor. Because it would be interesting.
Yeah, it would be to actually see you guys interact. And we're going to need his help anyway, so now that we have him here.
Alright, has everybody written their beliefs?
Yes, sir.
Alright. Brent, you going to do the recap?
I can.
Alright.
Shane, you don't need a fate right now, do you?
No, sir. I'm sitting on 7 right now. I'm just going to grab a pencil.
Everybody's my ass in fate. Alright, so after defeating the rock golem, we set an improvised trap that the orc wanted to set and the elf was against.
And they
they got into a power struggle, and somehow the little elf beat out the orc in the power struggle. Keeping his rope, we set the trap. We snared. What we found out was the king of the dwarves, Bardor's father.
Renthar the Elder.
Yes.
I like that.
And Shane, I shared his sheet with you in the drive, so you can take a look at it.
Oh, awesome.
From there, I, as the elf, tried my best to free him, accidentally telling the king that, or Renthar, that the orcs had it, not remembering that all dwarves hate orcs horribly.
Everybody has a distaste for orcs.
So from there, I drew a blade on the king of the dwarves as the elf, starting this gigantic dialogue that ended with the son of the king renouncing his family. After all of this boiled over, we actually started talking about it and came to tears between the son and the king about family matters. I, weeping almost, had to apologize for my life as the elf.
Renthar apologized. He apologized for his crass actions.
Yes. We found out that Swy, Titus's dog, was cursed with a spell from an orc shaman that caused it to turn into stone slowly. Luckily, that orc showed up in a caravan we called to help us clear out this cavern of gold. We talked to the shaman. Swy is semi-fine now. We're not exactly sure what's still happening with him. We know that his fur is slightly stone. Knife when I tried to cut it. I think that pretty much wrapped up the session almost, hitting the key points. I don't know if anybody...
Yep, that was it.
...had anything they wanted to add. Now, we basically are waiting for our next move out of this cave.
All right. What's everybody's new beliefs?
I kept my one. I feel that I repaid my debt to Twinkles by stepping in and making sure that your father did no harm to him.
Yes. Yeah, no problem with that.
So that belief, I just kind of scratched out that I owe him a debt, and I still have that I'll keep him safe and make sure that he's treated fairly and with respect. This orc poses a new threat. We must protect. I must protect and aid my companions at all costs. That's all the same belief. I just tied it all in together.
Nice.
One of those. It's actually a philosophy. If you
don't know how good that was.
I must steal away to my cache secretly and gather my valuables for the coming journey. I still have not accomplished that, so that's one of my beliefs. A new one that I wrote is, I will use my tracking skills to locate this deadly orc and assist in ending this one way or another.
Nice.
Probably somewhere in the middle of this, if I get to my secret cache, that belief's going to go away, and that bloody rag that we had, I want to somehow tie that into one of my beliefs where we find out that it's either useful or not useful, if you get what I'm saying.
That's okay.
Yeah.
We'll worry it later.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I know how we can use that. That's great.
Who's next?
I can go.
Go for it.
Well, I told you when I was stripped the orc of his powers, and I'll just put make them mine. So just to simplify it, I know y'all can make it more elegant, but that's what I put.
Speak up, James. Quit whispering.
Oh no,
whispering, muttering.
You can hear me.
Don't be scared of the mic.
So basically, he says he's gonna take the orc's power and make it his own.
So James like it.
Yeah, and then I will seal the forgiveness of Bardor's father by proving myself loyal and reliable to my comrades. And he counts as one of my comrades since he's kind of in the party.
Shane, did you get a new camera?
No, I'm using a different one, and I have more light.
Ah, I was about to say, it looks a little bit better. All right, so Brad, what are yours?
All right, mine is, we'll make sure Bardor's cut of the gold makes it back to the city or wherever he sees fit. I will try to further my relations with the dwarfs by showing I am trustworthy, brave, and honorable. How's that one? I'm good? I'm okay?
Yeah, that's all right.
And I will find out more about this blind orc so I can further help my party. Such as getting research on him.
That would work.
Because I'd like to know what I'm up against.
The only thing I can see about maybe that second one, like somewhere near or in this game, you find a way that you can do that. Mm-hmm. Write that in as the belief.
Maybe go to a library or something.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, my question is how?
You look around this cave a little bit more.
All right, so are we ready? Did you read yours, Shane?
Yeah, mine is going to be, we've done a great disservice to all the world by releasing Hugh, who is blind. And basically, I'll pull together every resource I have to thwart the foe. Second belief is Zig's heroics are an enigma to me. If he's so skilled, perhaps he can help us stand a chance against the foe. I'll collude with my companions in convincing him to our side. And then I've got my oaths about fitting everyone out with armor and building my workshop.
Yep. So you took that one back.
Which one?
The workshop. Disowned your father and everything.
Well,
renounced the workshop.
Yeah, I renounced it, but I felt like in the end of this situation, it was like a powwow, and so it was kind of like, you don't have to renounce it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I mean,
if I misunderstood
that, you know, let me know.
No. That's fine. I just wanted to make sure.
Shit got hectic.
I didn't know if you were just going to go ahead and just stick with breaking it, or...
Yeah, because he didn't exile me for it. He wasn't like...
Yeah.
We ended up making up before it was over.
He said it in heat of the moment type deal.
So,
it's all known by.
We got it all out there. Now we're still in the cave. Go.
Now what we're doing is transporting all the gold, right?
That's up to you. And you could be transporting it. You could try and get Renthar to transport it.
All right. How about we each split up and do like a different job?
Sounds good to me.
All right. I'm going to take care of making sure that we get all the gold to the carts. I'm going to do that by just getting the dwarves together. We're just going to get started on that. We're going to do that thing. Brad, why don't you look around the cave for lore?
I can have me and the orcs kind of like, just like keeping an eye out, like not quite guarding, but patrolling.
We already have the humans.
The humans are patrolling?
Yeah. They're on. Brad's already got them.
Okay.
Working on that deal.
Oh, yeah, okay. I remember last game. I don't know.
All right, Shane, so you're going to command the dwarves?
Yeah, I want to take responsibility for gathering the treasure.
All right, well, that's going to be a command test, unskilled.
All right, I'm going to step up and step to the plate and be like, Dad, you know, I know you brought these dwarves under your command, but if you don't mind, I would like to take charge because this is my treasure, I found it, and I would like to make sure that it is handled safely and with respect.
Treasure?
As you wish.
Have a bigger percentage of the gold.
He says, as you wish, my son.
Good. Well, if you don't have any problem with me taking care of this, I will just see to it. And I walk over to the four dwarves, and I get their names.
Okay.
And say, all right, you know, I think you guys know what to do.
You guys sleep.
And what's my obstacle?
I was about to name out the dwarves.
Seven.
It's going to be a 2, so that's a 4.
All right, I hit a 2. So that's a failure.
You hit a 2.
Okay.
So,
sleepy.
As you're over there barking orders, you're trying to tell them what to do. They're just kind of leaning on their hammers and their axes. And one of them, Banthier, says, listen here, young blood. I don't know who you think we are, but we came here under order of your father. And we will not have his seed order us around. We take orders from him.
He just told me to take charge of you guys. What do you have to say to that?
I would have to say I must hear it from his mouth, not the mouth of babes.
Fine. Dad, come over here.
And so... Renthar comes over. Well, what's all the fuss about, son?
Well, it's no fuss. There's really no problem. It's just Banthier here seems to be a little irritable. Maybe he didn't have enough to eat.
You know you're my princess.
Banthier! What is this issue that you have with my son? Banthier kind of straightens up. He's like, there's no issue, sir. I just... You are the leader of this expedition, and I did not think it was his place to give us orders.
That's right. Banthier, we're all friends here. I just want to make that clear. But remember whose family you're dealing with.
And as you say that, Renthar kind of leans in and looks at Banthier.
It
says, yes. Remember whose family you're dealing with here.
Like right behind him. It's good to be the king.
And at that, Banthier is just kind of, he's kind of like giving you the eye, but he's like, all right, you got me. You called in the boss. I see what you did.
Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna walk over to Banthier and pat him on the back and hand him like a piece of jerky out of my pocket. Hungry? Why wait?
So he takes the jerky, says, I appreciate it, but you didn't have to go cry to Daddy about this.
Well, I'm in a position of power. I'm not here to make friends. It's lonely at the top. And, I'll be sure you get a good cut of the buns.
As you say that, his ears kind of perk up, and he says, he just looks at you and says, well said. And he... gets his buddies, and they get on their merry way.
All right,
now, as that all is going on, who else was doing
something? Can I just send everybody off with a song to get the dwarves working?
Yeah, you can do that.
I'm going to be belting out a song about actually what happened here. It's a typical heroic song, but there's two lines in it where one person has to speak up and say what happened.
Okay.
And what I'm going to say happened, I was going to make sure all the dwarves know, I'm going to spend a little bit extra time singing the part about Zig.
Oh, yeah?
Because I want them all to know about what happened with Zig.
Okay. Now, who is going to be the one to respond? Is it going to be me?
It's just the odd, like, I'm singing the song.
Whoever in the group. I gotcha. It's in the group.
Yeah.
Just so it's their obligation to respond.
Exactly.
So you're going to sing a part about where he got hit and turned to stone and survived a crushing blow from a goat?
Exactly, yeah. And then there's And then there's like a chorus that like everybody knows. It's like about the history and the heroics and everything. And then you say something, you know, the song. The verse is like something specific that you just did, and then you go back and like, oh, the heroes take this opportunity. Are bold and great, blah blah blah.
Okay, well go ahead, let's do it.
All right, you want me to roll on that?
I mean, is it an actual skill? Or are you just going to test your sing?
I have stentorious singing. It's like a dwarven singing.
Aha!
I'm just trying to get everybody in the mood and the spirit to work, you know, because they seem to be kind of resistant to me. But I also want to inform them about Zig. It's like a twofold intent there.
Well, we'll just do a graduated test then. We'll see how well you do. It depends on how well people listen to you.
Okay, I'm going to do stentorious singing, and I'm going to raise up my hammer and, like, bang it on a piece of metal, and it has, like, a certain sound, like, ping, ping. Yeah. It's like, I'm fishing for an advantage.
Okay. All right. I'll give that to you.
Can I fork him a sing
to
chime in?
You want to lift
if
up
he will let you.
Yeah. I need,
I'll take the help.
Don't want to hear a fork sing.
All right, so Scotch is giving you a die. He's giving you an advantage die. So that's one advantage that you got, and a helper die from Brent.
Yeah. We make good harmony. I get the bass tones, and you get the baritone.
Yep.
All right, four die. Open-ended.
Yep.
Oh, I was going to help him. Do you think etiquette could help him?
No.
Ooh, here we go. Oh, snap, Hayes. Okay. Three successes.
You got three successes.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Three successes on four dice.
Okay, so. I will say with three successes, everybody's tolerating it. Not everybody is chiming in and dancing, but. It seems to visibly lighten the atmosphere. Everyone seems to be a little more easy going, and they are paying attention to the words that you're speaking.
Okay, great. I'm gonna step out of the spotlight there and get busy collecting all this loot. Where's the wheelbarrow?
Here, sir. Says Matthew as he rolls the wheelbarrow over to you.
Yep. And I'm gonna just get busy. All right, guys, what are y'all doing?
Go ahead. Well, Shane, let's do it.
My character would want to like ask your character if what can me and the orcs do? Cause I'm not sure.
Well, you have hands. They're the greatest gift you have. You know, dig in and start helping with this gold. We're willing to split the profits.
Okay, so we're just gonna help the dwarves load it up.
Yeah, I think it would be good.
The dwarves will be ferrying it.
I think it would be good for you guys to make friends.
Create a daisy chain. Start loading gold.
Let's pick up my martial arts training and lift properly. So I'm like, cool.
Nice.
Stuff like that.
Okay. So you're like throwing cups up in the air and then kicking them out of the air into the wheelbarrow. And, like, just toss the shit and punch it, and it's, like, going flying in the air.
Pretty much.
You're in love their punch.
He's like, hey-ya! Or he's like Dale from King of the Hill. Sh-sh-sha!
Stop your sh-sh-sha.
Stop. Stop the sh-sh-sha.
At least I actually know what.
All right, so while everyone else is busy,
She's going to sing his song.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry.
A song.
And I got to help with that.
Yeah.
I forgot, so I can't do anything right now except for help sing.
Mm-hmm. So we just have to.
All right, Shane, let's go.
Oh, you actually want me to sing?
Singing a song.
Do you want to? It's up to you, man. You can at least just speak it.
Okay.
If you don't want to sing, just speak.
Okay. The heroes of time are great and old. The heroes of time are getting old. Zig, the crazy one. Crushed by a hand, looked to the right, and there was the man.
Zig just like cocks his head at you as you're singing. He's just kind of looking at you like, what the hell is this guy doing?
And that's when I'll chime in, and I'm not singing the verse because I don't have a pretty voice like you do, but I'll sing that almost exact same verse again to help you out there.
Okay. So everybody's kind of looking at Zig, and Zig's just kind of like chilling, looking at everybody else like,
what do you want from me, guys?
What do you want? As he's still sitting atop the stone pile.
All right. I'm going to take a break and clean my hands, and I'm going to get the party together, and we're going to go have a private chat while all this noise is going on so Zig can't overhear us.
Okay, so everybody's chanting and singing, and they kind of pick up after a few verses, and all the dwarves and even Renthar is in there kind of humming and singing, and everybody's kind of bustling about. You know, the orcs are heaving mounds of gold into the wheelbarrows, and the dwarves are being very very intent on their task and wheelbarrowing everything out, and the humans are just kind of outside patrolling, making sure everything is safe.
All right.
Makes me think of the local song.
So we're about to have a conversation about Zig, fellas.
That's an awesome work song.
Let's do this. What's on your mind, dwarf? What is on your mind?
Well, Zig is obviously very skilled.
I agree. That would have killed a normal man.
Or
a normal human.
Any.
Hey now, we are tougher than we appear.
Though it seems.
At least some of them, man.
At least some of them.
Just thinking about when you were running, when we were walking to the cave.
Hey, man.
You're on our time.
You rode in the cart, Pansy Man.
Hey, that's... no, we didn't. Yeah, we didn't have a cart back then when we walked the rest of the way.
You rode in the cart to get up. That's why I was tired, because I walked with...
the cart. Oh! I thought it was just because you're a human. No.
You were nonchalantly had your toes up.
Yep.
Painting them.
And I'm all like, work smarter.
Getting your hair did. All
right.
So anyway, talking about Zig.
So, you know... We're all in this together, and I think he would greatly help us get rid of the foe, but I just don't know what to think of him. I don't know, and I'm trying to figure it out. And he eludes me. He eludes me greatly. And it's my feeling that we need to really pay attention to what he wants.
I'm obviously a little skittish of...
Well, we know what he wants already.
What does he want?
Right. Send him an arm and weapons.
I swore him the oath, but he doesn't seem to care too much to me, if you ask me.
Like, for you to outfit him?
Yeah. He doesn't show a whole lot of interest in it. I'm a little skittish about his knowledge of what we're fighting, I guess, maybe. He knew he was going to be fine going into this. He was even arrogant about it.
Yeah, he just strolled in.
That's true.
I'll be fine.
Would it be if he didn't knew what to expect, right?
He knew what he was getting into.
Well, you saw the look of surprise wash over his face when the orc appeared.
I say if we want to pursue this, we do it with extreme caution.
Okay. You know, give him what he wants.
True.
I mean, give him what he wants.
I was referring to the goal.
Interesting.
I say we're going to do it. We do it with extreme caution.
Okay. So, who wants to take charge of speaking with him?
I'll do it. Let the human.
All
right. Let Titus do it.
I got no problem talking to Zig.
I'm a sideballer.
Alright, if you need our input, you know, just call us over to your side and we'll get involved in the conversation.
What all do you want of him? Just another companion?
We need his bow. I mean, we need his skills and abilities. We need his advice. I would value his advice almost more than my father's in fighting.
Those are strong words. Good thing you can't hear us. All right, so we're gonna call him over, I guess. Or Brad, Titus is gonna call him over.
That's fine. When everybody gets back to work, I can just go over there and talk to him.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
All right. Well, actually, let's call my dad over for a second and see what he has to say about Zig.
Okay.
All right. Father.
Now he's kind of just hammering away over there at a big pile of gold. Looks like possibly some of the gold together. It's just a big mound. He's got a hammer, and he's wailing on that shit, trying to break it apart. Can't hear you over the sound of the hammer.
All right. Have to walk over and tap him on the shoulder.
He stops in mid-swing, and he turns, and he looks at you. What can I do, my son?
Well, Dad, you know, we're all mining this gold, and you know, I'm sure we're going to put it towards raising my workshop, but also we've got this foe to defeat. Me and my buddies have an idea. Do you know anything about that Zig guy over there?
Zig, you say? As he says that, he kind of just looks over at him. Zig's still sitting there, sitting on the rocks, hands in his pocket, kicking his feet, and his feet are dangling. He's just sitting there.
Oh, I forgot he did that the whole fight, too. Shit.
Well, he's just sitting there, just hanging out. Ah, this human. I do not know much of this man. I do know he is quite odd for one of his species.
Mm-hmm.
But, I've heard nothing of him in the city.
I'm just going to say the word sorcerer.
Sorcerer?
Yeah, I'm just going to ask. Sorcerer? Question mark.
Well,
he turned his flesh to stone.
Us dwarves are highly if he were a sorcerer, I believe I would be able to tell, but he seems like not much of anything to me. I mean, he's just one very small man.
That's not ironic at all. You know, we explain his exploits to my dad.
His legs feet stop.
What? Say that again? The mic was messing up.
We explain his exploits to my dad. Like, I'm not going to say it all out, but basically the bow and, you know.
Okay.
And I've explained it with the song already, too. I want to get his feedback on that. Like, do you think we can use his help? Do you think he will figure into our mission, Father? I know you have skills in runecasting. Can you tell me the future? And does he play a part in it?
Well, Well, without runecasting, I could say that if he has truly done the things you have described, he must surely be a formidable friend or foe.
Mm-hmm.
With runecasting, it's very delicate and intricate ceremony that I have to complete. And he actually has to be willing. And from what I have heard, he seems to be very independent. And I doubt he would accept any help from us.
But what about any of us? Do you think any of our fates are entwined with that of Zig's?
I could see. I can check. So, question is, who? He's looking around. He's scanning the room. He's seeing faces of the companions, and he stops on the elf.
Can I play my little crazy trait here and act a little skittish about this?
Yep.
I'm kind of going to want to back away from this. I don't want to know my fate.
What is wrong, elf? You seem as if you were afraid of this man.
I am. No, I'm scared to know my own fate.
You're scared to know your own fate. Well,
I feel it might impact the way my judgments.
Rune casting is very difficult. It's very difficult to see the full scale of the future. What I can offer is just bits and pieces of information that you can make your own assumption out of. Whatever I say doesn't necessarily mean you have to do as the fates have spoken.
But fate is fate. It could surely end the way you speak of.
I'll try my best to tolerate it, if you wish to tell me. I'll try my best.
Okay, well, come here. Stand beside me.
Yes, sir.
So he stands beside you, and he reaches down. He grabs some stone. Just grab some stone off the ground. Grab some stone, and he pulls out a toolkit, and he starts etching these runes into these stones. As he's doing this, he's kind of humming a dwarven tune, and it turns from humming into singing. And as he gets done, he stops abruptly. And he turns, and he faces Samuel.
I'm visibly shaking.
He throws the stones down at Samuel's feet. Up. What's a six? Seven successes. So, he bends down as he's reading the runes. He's speaking in a dwarvish language that nobody understands except for his son, Bardor. He studies them very intently, and he gets down, and he's looking at them, and he's seeing how they're laying. He's seeing which runes are facing up, which ones are turned which certain way. And the runes are kind of glowing. He's just, very carefully studying these runes. And as he stands up, he looks at the elf. He says, "Elf, I do not know much about your path and this strange man, but I do know that a power that you will need on this journey can be found in seclusion in the woods."
In these woods?
In these woods. But you're going to have to sacrifice something very dear for such power.
Two questions. Do you know where in these woods?
I have no clue. I just know that it is in the woods.
And you can't tell me what I might have to sacrifice.
The stones do not reveal all.
My skittishness kicks up a little bit. And I'm obviously worried. I'm obviously nervous.
You're obviously worried and nervous? Okay. And as you're nervous, the dwarf stands up and he slaps you on the back. He's like, "Relax, elf, relax. Some say these are merely more than just parlor tricks, although dwarfs know better than that."
I know better.
He's kind of ribbing you as he says.
Sarcasm. Say no more.
Yep. So that is that. Is there anything else that you would have of me?
Mm-hmm. Your wife. No, I'm just kidding.
Your wife.
I like lean over to Titus and I whisper in his ear because he's all into information. And my dad can touch stones and listen to them and learn the history of what the stones have seen.
That is a really good trick. Wish I had something like that. I have to just go off of knowledge, and it fails me most of the time.
All right, so I'm gonna start walking towards the entrance after learning this from the king.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't walking away, I'm just gonna tell everybody that I need a minute, and if I'm not outside, I'll be back. And a few, don't leave me stranded here, if you would.
Okay.
So I'm going to kind of walk towards the cave.
That's right. Fine. Hang on just a second. I might want to give him something to part with.
Is it a union weaver? Dwarf?
I want to
yes,
keep
him. Do you have a...
I approach him. Keep him in line.
I'm trying to figure out. I want to give you something to walk
I'm not
out with.
Him at all.
Yeah, my character would probably look at James and be like that towards Brent walking away. Be like,
I'm fine. I'm still inside the cave. I'm just nearing the entrance. I just want. It's obvious that I, after learning this and the fact that I might have to sacrifice something that's near and dear to me,
yeah. Like
I want some time
the face, doesn't it?
Alone almost.
Are you armored?
I'm not right now.
Right.
Well,
don't worry about it. I was trying to see if I had anything. You have traveling gear, right?
Yeah, I have traveling gear.
Okay, so forget it.
Yeah.
I give you a piece of beef jerky.
What was that?
I give you a piece of beef jerky.
Oh, thank you, sir.
I'm like,
yeah, I'll eat it on my nerves.
All right, now, don't be
too long on my nerves.
Don't be too long. I know you elves need to go and lament your sorrows in private.
I appreciate it. So I'm just kind of going to go wander off by the door, and I'm going to stand there for a minute and just kind of watch. People watch what's going on.
All right.
I'll work and do. I'll work and watch him at the same time.
You're working and watching him, all right?
I got
I'm getting some lag.
Zig now?
Sure.
Okay. All right. Zig's still just sitting there on the rock.
Well, I'm going to approach him pretty warmly. What's up, man?
He just nods at you. That's all he does.
So I got to ask you. It's been eating at me. I can tell that you have a lot more hidden skills than you portray. I noticed that you're good with the bow. Somehow darkness does not blind you like it does me, because you can see in it somehow. And you took a mighty hit from that rock monster, which maybe my eyes failed me, but I'm pretty sure I saw you get hit. I gotta ask you, man, how you do it?
Well, as far as the darkness, I've been able to see in the darkness for as long as I can remember. And the bow just comes from working. Being a hunter, gathering food, once you've been doing this for so long, you tend to amass certain skills. And as far as this rock monster, surely your eyes must have been playing trick. You saw how giant and strong that creature was. Any man would have been crushed and killed instantly if he had been hit by it.
True.
Are they saying it missed him?
So you're from the forest, I take it, then? Because I'm pretty well known in the city, and I have pretty good reputation with almost all the humans. And I do not know of you.
I'm a person who is not very important. I doubt many would know of me. I'm just a normal man.
You think of yourself lightly.
I'm modest.
Just to clarify, I'm out of earshot. I can't hear this, right?
No, no.
So tell me, what do you have planned after all this is said and done?
Well...
Will you go back to being a simple mercenary for the dwarves once again?
Once I collect what is owed to me, I may. Or I may take a long trip across the countryside. I tend to do whatever I feel like doing at the moment.
Understandable. So how would you feel accompanying us and trying to figure out this blood orc, or blind orc, and blood orc?
Well, you ask such a frail man to undertake such a strong task. I must say I'm quite shaken by this orc.
I,
as he's steel faced the whole time.
Because I doubt you're really that scared.
Oh, Zig. I was trembling in fear just like the rest of you.
He was.
That is true. He did not look that scared.
Oh.
I'll say it was you thinking of a rather smart plan.
Oh.
Your hands were in your pockets.
They were. That they were. Yep, he's just sitting there. He's not offering any more to the conversation. He's just sitting there. He's not going to dialogue with you. You're going to have to pull. You're going to have to pull stuff out of him if you want anything out of Zig. All
right.
Damn. He's a puzzle, man.
Well, Zig, I will tell you personally that I do enjoy your company. Now, do I see you as a frail man? But I see you as no such thing. You do seem battle-worthy. You're reliable, no matter what your actions may portray. And as modest as you're trying to say that you are and simple, I believe that you could be very trustworthy.
All he does is look at you, tip his hat. That's it. That's all he does.
I may require your assistance later, and if you wish to come with a deal or an agreement, I would enjoy your company later on, once we get this gold transported.
And he sits, and he looks like he's thinking about it a little bit. And all he says is, "We shall see."
How far away is the king from you?
The king? He's hammering away at that pile of gold again.
All right, so I'm going to stealthily, using observation, I'm going to wait until the orc is turning his head, doing the business that he's doing. Using my observation, I'll roll for it if I have to.
Observation is trying to find things.
Trying to find things I can't.
Not spotting weaknesses and moments of opportunity.
That's right, I forgot. So, let me use stealth then.
All you can do is, I would say, you can stealth.
I don't have any conspicuous. That's the one I wanted to use.
Well, you can stealth. I mean, nobody's really paying attention to you.
I'm going to stealth. I'm going to go out of the door. If any of the humans question me, my thought and train already is I need time to myself. Do not bother me, human.
What's up?
I'm going to disappear
okay.
into the woods.
All right. So, James, were you going to try and keep an eye on
Senor Ricky?
On Senor Samuel?
What I'm doing is I'm digging through the gold, right? But I'm looking between my legs in his direction.
We got to go over perception to see if you see him sneaking
that's
out.
Agility perception. That's a weak test.
Yeah. Agility perception?
I'm going to say because
you want me to roll my stealth and give
doing
me...
another task, and you're kind of half paying attention, you're going to be at an extra ob.
Okay.
So you're going to be an ob one on top of
Brent's stealth.
The ob three. What's your stealth, Brent?
Four.
Your stealth's a four, so you got an odd five.
Odd five.
You want me to roll
that? Yeah. I think I can do it. Is my perception
something? It doubles, Hayes. It doubles because if he doesn't have observation, he can't spot stealthy.
Oh, yeah. So you're looking at like an ob ten.
That's ridiculous.
You can do it.
It would be an all persona.
Whatever, let's do this. I'm trying it anyway.
Any test for it. Test. Oh, yeah, you can open up. Yeah, you can open up observation. So go ahead and write down observation is being learned.
Observation. It is.
And what is your perception?
Three.
His perception is a three.
I would use a persona and a face.
So it'll win. It's seven, so it's why? Six. You gotta do six more tests.
They should roll against each other.
They should roll against each other?
As I say, I'm down.
Okay, hell yeah, we'll do that.
Wait, go ahead. I mean,
Brent will go ahead and roll.
Would that add to his...
No, he's just going to roll his stealth, and I was going to set the obstacle instead of it being a 10.
Yeah. Ah, okay.
So he's going to go ahead and roll his stealth.
It'll be this doubled plus one.
That's ridiculous. That's fine.
That's one. Only three. I got a one.
You got a one, two, yeah, three.
I'm going to get you.
Yeah, it'll actually be a four, because it's one the plus the ob, and then
double. And double dog,
yeah.
Now Brent might have to shake it.
And let's see if I get to use a fate.
He's like, what is that, the talisman?
No. Damn.
Alright, so I made it outside.
So, Sam makes it outside undetected.
Alright. The next thing I really want to do is, can I get past the humans?
You don't see any humans.
Okay, so then I'm going to go for my cache really quick.
All right.
Do I need to orientate myself with Song of Path and Ways to get there?
We'll go ahead and say Song of Path and Ways.
I'm going to use Sing, obviously, with that, making it 5 in my neck of the woods for advantage.
Okay, so we'll just say that's an ob...
100.
It's an ob 3.
All right. Come on, don't get lost, Sam.
Bobby Fischer.
Like that, right? Gonna bust a fake because I only got shit. Another 6, that's 3, 4. I got 4.
Okay, so, you got 4, so.
What did I get from my song? That was a routine, right?
Yeah, that was a routine. Because it was a 3 and you rolled 6 dice.
Yeah.
So, you're making your way through the woods, quite uninterrupted.
Wait, what? How did my stealth test there? I'm sorry.
What, your stealth?
Yeah, how did that test?
Oh, I didn't make your roll.
That was graduated.
Yeah, because you were just away from everybody, so I was just like, move yourself.
I was saying I rolled for the ob. You know,
yeah.
So it's just graduated. You rolled. It's a routine.
And, well, how does that handle? How many dice did you roll, James?
4. I rolled 4. I only have 4 for stealth. I couldn't fork anything in.
That's got to be.
James only got 3, though.
Maybe a difficult?
He rolled 4, I rolled 4.
That would be difficult for me.
Yeah, but it depends on, like, if he rolled 1.
It would be
a
difficult. Either way, he only beat you by 1.
Yeah. So,
true. Just write difficult. Yeah. The obstacle is your, what you roll.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but... Does that work with perception?
Yeah, I mean, but the thing is, you use the observation.
Oh, okay.
And you were opening that skill, so you got to do observation 6 more times.
Okay. My bad. I wanted to learn that.
So, as you are making your way to your little cache, roll your perception.
100.
Ob 4.
Vanish from my neck of the woods. Just kidding. I'm not gonna do it again. I don't know what I'm getting into. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
That's a pass for my perception.
Yeah. Yep, that is a pass. That would be a difficult for your perception. So, as you are making your way to your cache, you hear something. You hear something that catches your ear, and it's not an animal.
It's footsteps.
It's almost like a song. Hmm. You hear some music. It happens to be coming from the direction where your stash is.
Can I use observation to spot something, huh?
You can.
Like footprints to pick up how many there are? That would be tracking.
That would be tracking.
All right. So I'm going to use my tracking to see if I can tell how many footprints I'm about to walk into. You said I hear singing, and I only hear one voice. I hear music.
Yeah.
I don't know. I want to see if I can tell how many voices that I hear. This is me rolling 3.
I'll tell you this. it's not people singing. It's like an instrument is being played.
You know what? I won't do. It's just an instrument that I hear.
It's just an instrument.
You know what? It's my stash. I'll just walk up to it.
Okay. So you walk up to your stash.
Yes.
As you break the clearing, where your stash is, how is your stash secured?
It is, I would say, roughly, let's put it at maybe 2 feet deep.
Is it buried?
By a tree, okay. 2 feet deep, by a tree, in between the roots that I know grow.
Okay. So, as you go there, you'll notice there's a hole that's about 2 feet deep, by a tree, in between two roots that you know where they grow.
Well, you could have told me where it was.
And as you are listening, you notice the sound is coming from up in the tree. As you look up,
it's Zig.
Zig is sitting in the tree with your bag of items playing a flute that he pulled out of your bag.
And I'm just going to question as to what? Zig, how did you know about this?
I know a lot of things, Elf.
I noticed you know a lot of things. That's not what I asked you. I didn't ask you how many things you know. I asked you how you knew about a hidden stash that only I knew about.
Oh, you think that you are the only one that knows things about these woods.
I didn't ask you that or say that either. I asked you how you know about my buried stash that had grass growing over it in between two thick roots of a tree that I grew up under.
The earth speaks to me.
The earth speaks to you?
Yes, it does.
That is a magnificent gift that you have.
You could say it is a gift.
You would say it's a curse?
You could say it's a curse.
Oh, I guess you do hear some pretty awful things from the earth every now and then.
Possibly.
So, what do you want with my belongings, Zig?
Oh, it is not your belongings that I care for, Elf.
What is it, my friend?
Well, since we have first met, I noticed that you didn't really seem to take a liking to me. It seemed as if you might want to test this frail man who didn't sit quite right with you.
What gave you these indications?
Oh, I don't know. The lingering in the cave, the eavesdropping, trying to see what I know, what I can do. Normally a man does that if he wishes to test his mettle against another man.
I am a standoffish character. I will give you that. I love to be aware of my surroundings. As you know, it is a very particular skill to survival. If the earth speaks to you, you know very much of what I'm talking about. I have no qualms with you, except for the fact that you somehow know of my stash. You have done nothing to me. Don't think I've done anything to you to warrant any of this.
Oh, but you've caught my attention.
That's not always a bad thing.
Ah, but do you think it's always a good thing?
No, I didn't say that. I just said it's not always a bad thing. If we have common skills, we should work together. If we have skills that could benefit each other, I think we should work together.
You think you may benefit me?
I don't know. Honestly, at this point... You can do some crazy things that I didn't know about.
You're talking, he takes the flute that he was singing, that he was playing, and throws it into the woods. And reaches into your bag and pulls out a loaf of bread and starts eating it.
But I was hungry. Good thing that dwarf gave me this beef jerky.
So you look back at your hand, it's bread. He's got the beef jerky.
Zig, what do you want from me? Stop being so coy.
Well,
speak your mind, human.
I want you to take this bag from me.
You want me to physically take this bag from you? So you are provoking an altercation.
I want you to be able to fulfill your deepest desire to test your skill against mine.
Well, we can do that in a friendly game that doesn't involve bloodshed.
God.
No, we can do it.
I will use no weapons. You can use the weapons of your choice.
I'm not going to use weapons against an unarmed man.
Oh.
I also don't want to fight you, Zig. I have no reason.
As you say that, he pulls out a bottle of mirror wine, starts drinking it, and gets halfway through and looks you dead in the face and throws it into the woods.
Such disrespect. For no apparent reason.
I've told you what the reason is.
No, you
declined my offer.
You have been coy with me. All you were looking for is a bullied
fight. I'm telling you, I'm here to test your skill. You don't like me. Then I can tell.
You do not know me. And because you assume that I do not like you, you might be as frail as they say.
I say that. Bread, that's the beer wine. As you say that, he pulls out a bottle of Starlight. If you do not know what that is, it's a very expensive, rare bottle that is filled with Starlight. It's like a lamp. It's like a torch. It's something that's very important and very difficult to attain. He says, I guess I must be frail. And he cracks the bottle against the tree.
I remain, the
contents spill out.
I remain silent.
And he just sits in the tree and stares at you.
And we shall sit here.
All right.
I'm not getting into this childish altercation with you. You can have everything in that bag. If that is what you wish, if you wish to just rob a man blind for no apparent reason.
I'm offering you your chance to take
one. Then get out of the tree.
He hops down out of the tree.
How do you want this to begin?
You can begin however you want. I will give you the advantage. He takes his bow off and lays it down on the ground.
I'm just going to walk up and put my hand on the bag.
You put your hand on the bag? Power test.
Wait, does Brent want it? You want to pull it away from him?
No, I don't. I don't want to actually pull it away from him. My hand is just on the bag, and I want to look him dead in the eyes.
That's not a power test.
That's not a power test?
Yeah, you got to get the intent. You got to get Brent's intent.
My intent is just...
All right. Well, he's holding onto the bag, too. So you're just saying that you're both holding onto the bag.
So what now?
Mr. Ludo. Look, there's a naked lady. What? Ha ha!
Yes.
I'll fall for it.
Your weakness is fat.
I know. No, it's not. It's not what it says on my sheet.
I'm making my move.
Ah, you've only laid hands on the bag. You've not tried to take it yet.
I do not have to take something that belongs to me from you.
Do you
want the bag?
No. The bag is not what I am after.
Then why protest me?
Because I want to test your skills.
We can do this a different way.
Oh, no, this is the only way.
What leads you to believe this?
Oh.
How do you know me so well that you must test my skills and not know them, but know me so well? You've seen my skills. You know my skills, obviously. There's no point in this confrontation. I have let you destroy things here. Let you.
You started a dangerous game, Elf. In every game, there must be a loser and a victor.
Why do one of us have to be a loser?
There could be.
We are but players in a game.
You remain unarmed.
I remain unarmed.
Then you can obviously defeat me. What is the point in me shedding my own blood here for simple possessions in a bag that are nothing? What's the word I'm looking for here? But superficial.
Will you not give me this simple pleasure of a fight?
It is more entertaining for me to watch you cringe.
All right, I'm going to need you to roll your speed.
Roger that.
What'd you get?
4 successes.
He takes his hand, drops the bag, and thrusts his hands into your chest cavity.
Dealing
into your chest cavity.
Like I'm dead.
As you slump to the ground, he holds on. He snatches his hand out. He's holding just the bloody remains of your heart. And as he is holding it, he just kind of holds it up, and it ignites into flames.
Well,
now, as you were laying on the ground, he walks up to you.
Dude, he could roll fucking twos.
Listen.
He walks up to your body. Where the wound is in your chest, he takes his hand and draws a line down your chest, and the wound seals. Then he draws a symbol on your chest. And this is what the symbol is.
B-R-T-C-H.
God, this is ridiculous.
Rich, that's what you are. My bitch.
Just a symbol. As he does that, your skin raises up and turns bright red like hot irons. And then he reaches back into the bag and pulls out another bottle of mirror wine and pours it over your face. And you sit up, gasping. And he looks at you.
What you wanted?
And he says, "You are my servant now. What I have put on your chest is a mark. If you speak a word of what has happened here to any of your party members, your chest will open back up and you will surely die." And he tosses you the bag and walks off into the woods.
Well, that's a special belief for me. Fucking demon or something?
Pretty much.
He's gotta be. I watched what you roll there. That's metagaming, but I watched what you roll there. I could have busted a fate and maybe somehow miraculously got out of that, but I didn't.
Yeah, probably been worse if you did.
Hold that thought, Zeke.
So,
I need to know right now, out of game, what is a word?
What do you mean, what is a word?
If I get back and I look at Titus and I'm like, you need to be weary of your cohort.
You can say that. Okay. If you were like,
"Hey, he pulled out my heart.
Zig did this to me. I am dead right now. My chest cavity is hollow. I have no organs." There's some special traits you can pick up, too.
That's what I'm saying. I was going to ask if before he walked away.
Right now, your mortal wound, where your mortal wound is, put a G there.
If I could ask... My mortal wound?
Yep.
For gangster.
I was going to ask if when he walked away, or when, right before he exclaimed his whole thing, I was going to be like, "Yes, I'm master." Then.
Well, you can call him. You can call him back and ask him some questions if you want to. He's still in earshot. He might fill you in a little bit.
All right, let's say, please, after this ordeal, and my state of mind at this point is utterly confused.
I'm out of mind.
So Zig stops in the edge of the clearing and turns around.
Why me?
Oh, you were the one who first piqued my interest, my friend. I told you before.
You're so coy, Zig. I'm looking for more intricate answers, and if you're not going to give them to me, just leave them blank. If there are things I already know, just leave it blank.
I will tell you this. Your life force is now linked to mine. If anything were to happen to me, you will perish as well. When I have need of you, I will let you know. I will tell you what I will have you do.
I will know that you're safe unless you need me.
You do not need to worry about my safety.
Well, your safety is my safety now, Master, so I am worried.
He just looks at you, and he pulls his glove off, and as he pulls his glove off, you see a clawed hand, and he walks up to you and just touches your forehead, and your skin sizzles and burns.
Master, that's not what I meant. What I'm saying is I'm obviously...
Test your steel.
I'm obviously here to serve.
Test your steel.
All right.
In present, test your steel.
Like when I had my face burned off.
Run to a mob of black.
Three. What's your hesitation?
Six. Two or fail.
So, I'm not even going to give you an option to stand and drool here. What he does, as he goes from a finger to a full hand and grips your face, and it's just sizzling and smoke, and smoke is just billowing out from between his fingers, and you're just howling in agony, and he just leans you back on the ground and then lets go. And as you reach up to touch your face, there are no burns, there are no marks.
I just meant to aid you, Master. I didn't mean to offend you.
The fuck? And he just says, lesson learned. Puts his hands in his pockets and strolls back out into the woods.
What did my grief just jump to?
I don't worry about grief right now.
Yeah, that's got to be like an out of nine grief.
Yeah, I'm walking off into the fucking west right now.
Oh, you can.
I know.
You are alive while Zig is alive.
Yeah, all I wanted, that deck didn't get anything I wanted to out of him there.
All right, so let's roll. Let's roll and see what you got. Let's roll and see what you got in your stash.
What do I roll off of this?
You got an empty bottle of Stardust.
There was the flute that you could have got, which was a flute of lamentations.
He can still find that.
Elven mirror wine. He can roll perception to find that. He lost the elven mirror wine. He lost the bread, and he lost the starlight.
Yeah.
So.
All that. What did I get on my steel there? Challenging again, huh?
Yep. So,
one, two, three, four.
Alright, we're going to roll the die three times. One, two, three, and four are going to give you items.
I want this one rolled.
Alright, two is Elven Light Mail. So you did find some Elven Light Mail.
Alright, Elven Light Mail.
How does Stash work, though?
He came up with a list.
You found your Elven Cloak.
Hello?
And that was it. So you got your elven light mail and your elven cloak.
And a walking staff?
Yeah. Sure, you can have a walking staff. I'll give you a walking staff.
I don't need it. I'm just kidding. That's just for cosmetics.
What is this?
I want to be like the elf in the book.
Who?
I think Shane stepped away for a second. All right. Wow.
Tim.
All right, so my new belief that I just wrote down is I can't speak a word of what happened to me in the woods.
I don't agree.
We don't even know you left.
Yeah. Nobody knows that this is going down.
My new belief, though, is I cannot speak a word of what happened to me in the woods. You guys start questioning me and stuff like that later down the road, like when you're like, hey, what happened when you disappeared? I am not allowed to ever speak a word of what happened. I cannot show you my chest.
That's fine. I don't have fault with.
Yeah, I know who you are.
No, I'm just saying that's a special belief that I have to carry now. I have to.
I wasn't sure.
Right? Wouldn't you say so? I have to carry.
Oh yeah, I mean that's you can put that as an oath. You can put it as an oath.
I do got to
put it as a special. Okay, special oath.
I'm standing there at the golem. Is Zig still there?
You walked off to make sure everybody else was doing stuff.
You gotta. He stealth tested way higher than I did.
Yeah.
Brett, I'm not kidding. This is way outside the realm of the game. This is super metagaming. Hayes didn't roll any lower but 1-2, and that dude got 7. And he didn't roll a single 6.
But you can roll your perception. If you want to, roll your perception.
I thought I was still standing there. Like I got done talking.
You're not going to beat his stealth, bro.
I mean, he knows. You already know that guy's mingling.
You got 1? Okay, I'm not even going to roll. You didn't get it.
Nah.
We'll just say,
challenge.
How many did you roll?
You rolled 4.
You rolled 4?
You don't get anything because you failed perception. You gotta pass perception to get credit.
Oh, yeah, it is just perception you gotta pass.
Okay, what else is happening?
Yeah, that was a 5.
So what items did he get?
He got elven light mail and an elven cloak.
Not too bad.
All right, well, I guess we're doing all
you can
that.
Roll perception, see if you still want to find that flute.
I was just going to say, can I roll perception? Or that's observation, maybe I could roll? No, I don't want to do that. That's a lower.
Perception or observation, take your pick. It's going to be an op 4.
You can look carefully, right?
Yeah, if you wanted to.
Op what?
Op 4.
Look carefully.
Yeah, depending on how bad he wants it anyway.
4. 5. I'm rolling 5. I'm going to use my keen sight with my observation.
All right.
1, 2, 3. Plus than a fate. 4.
Got it. All right. Nice. As you're searching in the bushes, you find this flute, and it is a light blue, almost like a sky blue flute. And it has gold bands around it where the mouthpiece is.
Should I refer to it as a flute of lamentation?
Yep. You can do that.
You want to put a lumen on it?
No. I mean, it'll just be like one per scene, or once per session. You can use it once per session.
And lamentation, just to refresh my memory.
That's your sad song that lowers your grief.
Lowers my grief. Yeah. Okay, that's what I thought it was. Can I borrow your book? I didn't bring it. I'm just going to look up my armor real quick. My stats for it.
Your sad song.
All right.
How long is that?
Robin's doing that. What are we doing, Ace?
So, meantime, you guys are still toiling away. What do you want to do?
I'll make my way back.
While Brent was doing that,
just stand outside the cave.
I was just going to, I guess when I got done talking with Zig, I was going to go up and check on the humans, see if they got any shit going down or what they're doing, see if they're slacking.
Yeah, I wouldn't notice him. I still wouldn't notice him being gone.
No, you failed your roll. You would not notice
it. You got preoccupied. Smoker's like, fuck, what? He's like standing over you with a whip. He's like going.
Everybody doing that to me.
Licking his lips.
Shot in the face.
Talking to you.
The humans are outside. You go up and check and see what they found. What they found. And they're basically just real nonchalant. Like, there was a goblin that we found. He was like on a horse or some shit. We shot him off of it. Yeah, so that's about it. You know, we really haven't seen much of anything.
I guess maybe you see me stand there a little ghostly.
About this time, you could say Samuel walks up.
All right. How was the beef jerky?
Amazing. It's the only thing I had to eat.
Good, yeah. I made it myself.
I thank you for
from
that.
His own back.
Everybody likes it. Even my mule likes it.
Well,
what are you saying?
Not even eat meat.
What are you saying, Dwarf? And I pat you on the shoulder.
I'm saying I make good jerky.
That's what I'm saying, asshole.
I didn't know maybe you compared me to a mule. Maybe you're a servant or something.
You seem to have some new goods in tow.
I did. I went and found some things I had put away. With little to no trouble.
Very good. I'm glad you didn't see any trouble.
This awkward silence just, all right, I'm gonna go back to the gold and just fucking just start watching people.
Yeah.
Help people shit.
All right, so you guys have just been hanging out in the gold room. They've obviously got everything down pat. Are there any questions you want to ask?
I just want to ask my dad.
Anything at all.
My dad to read the stone in here before he leaves, since this is the sanctuary where the orc was laying. Can we get that out of him?
I will look in and see what I can find, son. So he walks over. What particular spot do you want me to look at, my son?
Like, you see that pedestal over there? The one where, like, the orc? And I'm going to tell him that's the spot.
Ah, okay. So, he goes over to the spot. And...
I want to be there watching because this interests me.
Okay, so he's over there and he's just kind of like looking at the stone. He's kind of running his hands over it, and he was just kind of checking it out. Structural integrity. You see him give it a little shake to see how well it was built.
So what he's looking at is where the thing spawned, right?
He's looking at the pedestal that the box was sitting on.
Okay.
So as this is going on. He's just kind of checking everything. He's nodding. He's kind of impressed by the build of everything in here. And he puts his hands on the top of the pedestal. And he kind of grips the sides. He closes his eyes. And his head kind of just rolls back. And his eyes roll back into the back of his head. And he's obviously in some sort of a trance. And his mouth is agape. And you hear whispers coming out of his mouth, but his lips aren't moving. And it's just wisps of information. I mean, it sounds like 100 people are talking at once, and you just can't pick out any one thing.
Oh, I'm going to try to do a perception check to see if I can jot down anything as fast as I could.
So, as he's doing this... Mm-hmm.
What you need to read is...
So he got... That bad-ish. 9 successes.
Nice.
So...
One mile more is melt one arm.
As he is holding on, so you see him kind of start to shake, and you see his knees buckle. And louder till it's shouting, and it's just filling the whole area. All the workers stop. Everyone is just in shock and disbelief of what's happening. When it becomes so loud that everyone is covering their ears, they just can't stand it. And all of a sudden, it stops. And as it stops, your father is thrown backwards from the pedestal into a pile of gold.
Mm.
Unconscious.
Yeah, I'm going to run over to him. You know, Father, are you okay?
Okay. He's still unconscious. He's not moving.
Is there any way that I can do field dressing?
He's not visibly wounded.
He's not visibly wounded?
Nope.
Damn.
We need to know what he learned.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do to try and wake him up?
Goddamn. All right. Does anybody have any wine or any drink? My father loves a drink.
All right. At the top of my lungs, I want to point at the shaman. And just be like, shaman!
Okay. The shaman comes over. She's standing there. She's looking at the dwarf, and she's like...
You got any smelling salts?
She doesn't know.
And she's like, what? Like, what do you want?
Oh, what does he want? Oh,
he touched the pedestal.
He touched the pedestal trying to figure out what it was with his rune magic.
So, what does that have to do with me?
Something. We're wondering if you would be able to tell what's going on with him. Why is he unconscious? You wouldn't know?
Shit, I don't know. And he got thrown back into a pile of gold. Does anybody have any food, water, anything they can pour on him?
I have a search in my bag. I have a traveling skin.
As you're searching, she turns around and spits on his face. A big, like, pile of mucus, like, right in his face. And just...
God, dwarves don't take kindly to that.
And he's like... What's that? And he's like touching his face, and like strings of saliva are coming from his fingers through his face.
Wasn't me.
He's like, what the hell is this?
I'm going to offer him my handkerchief.
So he takes the handkerchief and he wipes it off. And
if he tries to hand it back, I'm just
You keep that, buddy.
He's just like, what just happened?
I'm going to be like, Twinkles, teach your kind better etiquette.
I'm trying. So, he stands up with a little bit of help from you guys, and he's kind of shaking. He says, I've seen it, son. It's as if I was there. I've never felt anything like a presence like this before. It was so clear. It was as if I was not separated by stone, but I was one with the stone myself. Hmm. And he goes into detail and he starts describing what's going on. As best as I can tell, there are all these statues standing around. Now you'll notice the one statue where the orc broke free is off to the side. These other statues are surrounding this pedestal. From what I could tell, they had somehow used whatever was in the box with the chains to subdue this orc and to put him in a state of slumber. And it seems as if when this box was removed, and he looks at the orc,
kind of he knows
that
he said he was there. He can see.
He was awoken.
He can see what happened.
He touched the stone and like and he can see everything that happened.
Right? Oh, okay, I get what you're saying.
That's what it does.
He Yay!
And, like, see back in time.
He saw me scream out its name to get it off of James.
He saw me stand there and drool.
Yep.
Did he get to see me put my knife in his back again?
He probably
It stopped right there.
It stopped right there. He stopped watching as the dude, like, as he exploded out and started yelling and disappearing blood, that's when he got thrown.
That's when he got overwhelmed, is what it seemed like.
Yeah, when the golem was summoned.
I wasn't there, so I was for our own amusement that I asked that. I'm still outside, so.
Quick question.
Okay.
So the four there's four statues around the...
Yep, five statues total, four around the pedestal.
Okay. I don't know what your plans are for those statues, Hayes, but can I suggest that that one be a man, one be an elf, one be an orc, and one be a dwarf?
Yes. That is actually what I had planned on them being.
Oh, awesome. It's kind of like us.
Yeah, orc broke free.
Yeah.
Orc.
Well, that's badass.
Or the
golden cloak, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the thing's it's like a forge mask almost for elves.
It helps my spell.
So, it was of the different races.
Are all these statues just like, is it just a typical dwarf, a typical human, or is they actually got fine details?
They are, like, very well crafted. I mean, he can tell you that they are very important past figures.
Ah, God dang it, I was about to roll a champion one.
As a matter of fact, he's gonna roll ancient history.
I want to do champion wise on the human. Maybe my affiliation with the human.
You want to?
I'll ask you about this later because I don't completely understand.
Sounds to me like Brad wants to fight him on this and be the one to say what it is. Like he wants to interrupt him before.
All right, go ahead. Go ahead and roll your wise.
Hand it to me.
I got four.
I got 10.
But do I know of anything about this human? That's all I wanted.
No, you don't know nothing. That was a challenging test. You don't know nothing.
I can wear the cloak and my armor at all times.
Yep.
Together?
Yep.
Because all I'm going to do is be looking at the human like, trying to figure it out before he says anything. Just, damn it.
These beings of each race are the forefathers of all the races. I have heard stories growing up, being an old dwarf, of such a struggle taking place, but I would never thought that I would live to see the day where I could witness it firsthand. That's all it says. Yeah, that's all it says. You want to know more?
Yes.
Why don't you ask him?
Okay. I was just listening intently when he stopped. I was like, what?
So
what about these forefathers? What are the tales that you heard of? Why would you stop there, sir?
As the legend goes, there was each the strongest of all the races. Now, they kept the balance within the land, but one of the leaders somehow wandered and stumbled upon a great power. And he went mad and tried to enslave all of the other races and bring about an age of darkness. Now, being that it was so long ago, all of these creatures in the different races were basically like brothers. The four figures you see in front of you could not bring themselves to destroy their own brother, so they sacrificed their lives to keep him in prison. But yet, he has been released onto the land again.
So, may I ask what happened to these heroes? Did they just kind of die out?
They gave up their life force to stop this orc.
So it's just to imprison them in stone, so there's no way of bringing them back.
They are solid stone.
No way to bring the heroes back. Mm-hmm. We could be there.
There may be. I have no clue. I would not know this.
Stone of flesh. Wait, it's TNT. Oh,
well. All right, where's the Master Sword in here?
Where's the Master Sword? There is none.
All
right. It's actually this one statue's dick. You pull on his dick, and it pops off, and there's a sword on the end of it.
Our old perception plan.
That's what it is. You got to find it, but you can only find it with your mouth. It's like King Arthur.
Can I use both hands?
Or you can use your butt.
Can I use both hands?
Clench it with your cheeks. You might want to let James do that because he likes to take staffs.
In the butt.
But you can use the hands.
That's why I wanted the walking stick, honestly, so I can hit James next. So next time James was all like drooling over pretty ladies or whatever.
Oh, okay. God. All right.
I have yet to get the chance to do that.
I got about a half hour left to play. Just let me know.
Okay.
Okay.
Maybe I can finish my butt in so I can show
you. Well, I'm still sitting outside. My character didn't hear any of that.
So Renthar is still sitting there stroking his beard. I mean, he's just sitting in the beard. He hadn't moved. But he actually sat back down in the pile of gold, and he's still stroking his chin.
You know, Dad, I know you always tried to.
I still offer him something to drink.
He's waved you away.
Throw it on the ground.
Yeah. I'm going to collude with the orc. I'm going to be like, this is my dad's favorite. And I hand him like a mug of, you know, I don't know, something out of my
pocket. I try to hide my thumbs up. I go and offer it to him in the politest manner as I could.
He just takes it from you while he's eyeing you, just throws it back real quick and drinks it all. Hands you the flask back, and he just kind of...
Yeah, go back.
Yeah, tips his head to you.
Do the same thing.
Yeah. Go as back, he's still stroking his beard.
I'm useful.
Says, the last piece of information I can give you, son. Yeah. Throughout these legends passed down...
Mm-hmm. I do have many questions, but...
It is said that the spirit of these heroes may still roam the land. But I would not know where to start.
Okay. And I'm going to reach into my dad's chest and pull out his heart.
And pull out his heart, and it bursts into flames.
Oh, my God. Okay. You know, I'm like, well, thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad. You're the best. Go get my hat.
I really don't know where to take the conversation from here. I feel like we kind of got some answers we needed. I am going to look at my beliefs for a minute and try to kind of reorient myself.
All right.
Okay. So Dad, I know I've been asking you for a lot, but I need one more thing. Look, I'm going to fight for the resources that we gather from this cave. I want a big share because what I want to do with it is I have a dream. You know, I told you I'd build a workshop. Well, I really want to build a workshop that's a war room for launching attacks versus the great threats that marauded the land, this being the first one. And I think if our family name could take responsibility for thwarting such a threat, it would greatly increase our reputation throughout the land. And my workshop will bear the name of our family. And so I just need your help in fighting for the resources, you know, that we're claiming from this cavern, enough to build a war room, to build a workshop worthy of rolling out armaments of heroic quality.
We already claim half of this.
The dwarfs claim half of this, and last I checked, you are a dwarf yourself.
Now, on top of the 25% that you've got, that's 75%.
Do you think that's enough?
Math.
I've never been good with the accounting.
I think 50% of 100 yards of treasure, I would say that might would be enough, my son.
All right. And with that, I think if anybody else has anything that they any business they want to finish in this cave, I think it's
walk back in. Then I'm going to ask you for that rag with the blood on it.
All right, I'm going to hand it to you.
And look at his father, and the one last question, do you know how this could work, knowing what you saw earlier? Or do you know someone that I can give this to that would understand it better? Not saying, you know, not trying to be offensive.
And he just studies it, and he says, I have no clue. He would have to possibly take it to the city to find someone who would know. I myself know much about stone and metalworking, but not things of this nature.
Gotcha. You don't know of any dwarf that might could assist us in this area of magical expertise?
There are many in our clan. If you were to go back to the city, surely you would find someone.
Can I use your name?
Of course. Everyone knows us.
And then I'm gonna tell him thank you and whatnot, and then I'm gonna walk over to the shaman. I'm gonna grab Twinkles here.
Right.
I'm gonna walk over to the shaman and ask her almost the same thing. If she knows anything about how this magic would work, or if anybody would lead us in a good direction.
What she does when she sees the rag, her eyes light up big. She snatches the rag from you.
Power test.
You can power test if you want to.
I would like to, because I don't want to just give it to her.
Woot! Wait, is this shaman pretty?
Is this shaman pretty?
when she does that, I'm trying to explain to her that people take offense if you just...
She slaps you out of the way.
I'll
power test on you, too.
I was about to say, you're
going to... Go ahead and start talking. Get your power.
I was about to say, you're going to fork into me?
We're going to do it. Two separate tests. We're going to do James' power test.
Why is she slapping me?
Because you're interrupting her.
Can I see
that's all it takes, huh?
She sees something really important.
I failed. I got zero.
Power test.
I got zero successes, so... I just didn't want to give it that easy. Does power count as a roll without success?
Does it change? Do we know?
What was that?
Can you advance power without successes?
Yeah, it does, but it has to be a difficult or challenging test.
Well, that it was... She rolled a 5, so...
That would have been challenging.
Hey,
because he got 0.
I would like to claim an advantage. I'm a man, and she's... No, I'm just
kidding. I wish you would.
Nah, I'm just kidding.
And I'll be like, she knows spells. She can blow your fucking face off.
Disadvantage.
Disadvantage. No brains.
What am I rolling power for?
Because you tried to stop her, she's going to slap you out of the way, and you want to fight back and not be slapped out of the way.
I don't feel like... I don't want to be slapped
out. Go ahead and roll it, James. Okay. You said you wanted to.
Nobody got time for this.
I will use a straight point.
Well, that was
that wasn't a pass. These are 2 sixes.
I know, but I got 3 successes so far.
That was a 1.
Oh, you're... no, terrain change?
No.
Okay.
James, you just re-rolled another one.
No.
No, he doesn't get that free roll.
That was one of his sixes.
He doesn't. No, the 2 sixes are stacked. And
don't do that, man. I just re-roll it.
He tried to re-roll
it.
Just re-roll it all again.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Oh man, I probably would have been all right with that. Now it's gonna be bad.
You got your fate back.
See, now it's gonna be bad.
You got your fate back. You didn't spend a fate.
Didn't want to help. I didn't even get a 6.
Can't get nothing.
There you go.
Let's just get slapped right away.
She slaps the piss out of you and knocks you onto the ground.
First one would have been fine.
4 would not have been.
I'm going to put my hands up in a non-threatening manner. And I'm going to tell her the only reason I struggle is because I don't like things snatched from me.
She is not even hearing you right now.
Right.
She is like looking at that shit and what she does.
And she's got a really long nail, and she, like, takes some of the blood and scrapes it off the rag and holds it up so you can see, and it starts eating away at her nail. It's, like, dissolving her nail. And then she spits all that mucus and bullshit on there and, like, wipes it off. Yep.
Do you know what this is?
And then
you obviously know what this is. Can you tell me a little about it?
She says, oh, it's the blood of the Forsaken, is what she says to James.
I'll let you take the conversation from there.
it's the blood of the Forsaken.
Oh, you take the conversation from here, James.
Huh? What? You asked her that. I didn't ask her anything.
You obviously know where I'm going with this. I would like to know information about the blood.
What else can you tell us about his Forsaken blood?
It is the same blood that runs through mine and your veins.
Oh, because of, you know, that vile poison thing I can do? This is pretty much it, and it can eat away flesh, stuff, blah, 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 blah.
So, you're 100% on that, because I didn't hear her say that in any words.
Pretty much. That's what James told you, so you got to go off what James
said. Oh, God. All right, well, James, ask her if there's anything different about this compared.
Is there anything different about this blood?
She says, bad juju, man. That's what she
says. Bad juju, man?
Yeah.
I understood that. I understood
that. That's what she says. She says, bad juju.
I understood that. So you're telling me that this is a bad, bad omen.
She takes another claw and scoops up another claw and flicks it down on a little pebble. The pebble shakes a little bit. That stands up. Another little pebble's come up. That's a little teeny tiny elemental. Much like the big golem that you fall.
Do you know how this works? Do you know how that works?
No, I don't, but I'll ask this lady, so...
That's obviously what I'm getting at, translator.
Again, is there any way that we can control it, or is it controlled by the Forsaken One himself? She does not know?
I do not know.
It just starts, like, beating on you, that little elemental...
What happens if I rub this cloth on a big rock?
Don't do it. I just say that. She doesn't know, but don't do it.
Okay. This little rock guy, is he trying to fight anybody around us?
He's hanging around. He's
hanging around.
He's just like...
I'm going to stick the
handkerchief. He's like, all of a sudden, he became self-aware, and he's just like...
I'm going to stick this handkerchief back in my traveling gear.
Okay.
And leave it. Do I need to put it in... another question for you. Real quick, before I stick it in my traveling bag, do I need to put it in something? Do I need to put it in, like, a glass container?
Ziploc bag.
So it doesn't contaminate everything that it touches? Good idea.
It says the magic is pretty unpredictable. So it would be a good idea to separate it from those things.
She says it probably would be a good idea to separate
it. I'm going to put it in the only vial I have in my bag that's empty. Put a cork on it and put it back in my bag.
All right.
I pick up the rock elemental.
You going to pick up the rock
elemental? How big is it? Like this big?
It's like this big.
Yeah, pick it up and look at him.
Okay.
Does he do anything?
He looks at you. He lets out a little squeak, just like a roar.
Keep him.
Can you speak?
He just looks at you.
Keep him.
He spits a rock. He spits a pebble at your face.
Do you want me to crush you? Because I will.
Keep him
just,
for a little bit.
You were just born, you idiot.
And he starts like pounding your hand as you threaten him. He starts like pounding the palm of your hand.
I girl him kind of lightly and I shake him a little bit.
He's rock. He doesn't give a shit. You're shaking solid rock. He doesn't care. He's still pounding your hand.
Do I have any kind of... I put him in a sack.
You put him in a sack?
A little sack? You're going to wind him up in a sack?
When you can be good, I'll take you out. All
right.
Yeah. All right, James, you got a little pet rock.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, so...
How much more time you got, Shane?
I'm looking at, like, 15 minutes. You want to go ahead and wrap up here? Or?
Let's go ahead and wrap it up. We'll go ahead and wrap it up here.
I mean, we got a lot out of that one, I think.
I'm going to ask you...
This was your information. This was your information session. You got most of the information that you needed out of it.
Shane, I'm going to ask you... It's obviously, it's okay for me to keep this rag now, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I have no need of it.
Change my belief to steal that rag.
I have a vial of bloody rag. In my inventory. A vial of bloody rag. Nobody laughed, really? No
vial of bloody rag.
No one?
Really? Some wow, the handkerchief.
Trust me, I've been thinking about that since we got the blood off that thing. Like, the first thing I thought was, this is a mystical tampon.
He who drinks the blood of the mighty is really she who drinks the blood of the mighty. So the only person here who really did anything to their belief is Brent. Mm-hmm. Brent's the only one. Brent Martin down a fate point.
Woo.
Got my one back.
Where, do oaths go in a special place, or they go under beliefs just as an oath?
You can put it as an oath.
Well,
I was just saying, like, on this sheet, because I didn't see it.
What I wanted
just a note, I guess.
What I wanted to do before, like, you said we got done talking to the Father Dwarf man, I wanted to hand him an insignia, which is of the guard people that I'm with, of the royal clan. So if you ever need somebody, ask for the watch. And right. This is my insignia.
He takes and puts it in his pocket.
Yeah.
So... wish we could have gone a little bit farther, but we're all pressed for time, and it didn't. As soon as we all got done with this cave nonsense, shit would have hit the fan, and a lot of stuff would have gone down. But
we'll pick it up.
We didn't really have the time, so we'll pick it up next session.
Tomorrow. Okay.
What were you saying, Shane?
I don't work tomorrow.
I was gonna say, did you say Brent accomplished a belief, or
he went to his stash? He accomplished his belief.
Yeah, that's a persona. That's a persona.
Oh, that is a persona.
Yeah, the way it works is if you play off a belief in a convincing or entertaining manner, you earn a fate. If you accomplish a belief...
Brent gets a D's point because he did the rune casting.
Oh, he does get a D's.
Yeah. So Brent gets...
Because he followed his fate with the rune casting.
Doesn't that mean you can spend your grief if you want to?
No, that means I can double my dice or reroll failed dice.
I don't even know.
No, he can spend his grief. He can tap his grief with it.
Yeah, you can tap your grief with a persona and roll, add your exponent of grief to whatever.
I didn't know greed and grief work the same with persona.
Yeah.
No. Greed is persona. Grief is deeds.
Yeah. Grief is deeds.
Yeah, hatred.
Grief and hatred are deeds.
Okay, it doesn't say that.
Does it expend the deed?
I gotcha.
No.
Yeah.
It doesn't.
You use your deed or like fate and persona.
Okay. I gotcha. Okay. Yep. Back to four. Four. Yep, one.
I haven't been able to roll anything, so all I'm doing is I'm just stacking on fate and persona. I have so much.
Well, you're not getting any of this game.
So. I can't.
Well, if you play off of a belief, you get a fate, but it's got to be convincing, or it's you got to convince the GM that you played off of it, really.
Yeah. And I say we hold off on the rest of the awards because we really didn't get anything accomplished.
Yeah, that was a half session, really.
The only thing I was going to ask of the table before we left, too, was does my little crazy graduate now because of what happened to me in the woods? Am I slightly more crazy now?
You can graduate to batshit if you want to.
I don't want to. I'm saying does that seem... I don't want to.
Oh, so Brent wants us to do a trait vote.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Does that seem like something that my character should be now?
Well,
like, is it noticeable to you guys that it's happened, basically?
Of crazy, not really just more crazy. You can be a different type of crazy because of it.
Well, the way that works...
Well, they didn't notice anything because you didn't play out that you were shaking, or you didn't say that something is amiss with Zed. Yeah. Really... allude to the fact that anything happened.
Could have been like,
I was saying, the only thing I did when I walked up was I was ghost faced. Remember, that's the only thing I said.
Yeah.
Like I pale as could be for now.
I wish you if you had done something, I would have had Sid come up to me and be like, "Hey, buddy, what's wrong? You look a little pale," and then just walk off.
I feel like that was odd. Zig has not really engaged in any kind of conversation.
If he didn't do it, I said he would have.
You know,
that's what I'm saying.
I would have noticed it because how I was just talking to him, he fucking didn't give me any. There's no play. It was just me.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
All right, so I no longer have my steal my cash belief. Just to let you guys know, my other belief is obviously dedicated solely to my master.
Do you have my elven armor now what, all of a sudden?
Yeah. I can't help my companion if my master calls me.
Yep.
You get that from...
You guys you take a back seat to him. That basically what the belief is going to say.
There you have it. It's a belief.
Oh, it's a belief. Stash is a belief. I'm talking about how do you do stash.
That was his belief. He wrote a belief that was like, I must get to my stash so I can equip myself for the coming journey.
The
very beginning of the game.
That was like the very beginning of the game.
I didn't know you could do stuff like that.
It's the limit of your imagination is your belief. What do you want your character to do? And what his job as the GM is, anything I write down as my belief, is for him to throw a fucking zig at me.
Yeah. Hey, I challenged you. I threw a lot of shit out of your bag that was really important.
I know.
I destroyed a lot of stuff that was pretty important.
I couldn't really...
The bread's important.
Two vials.
I don't think you understand how important
two vials of mirror wine, that's just like healing potion, which is really hard to come by.
The starlight stuff?
The starlight shit, that's...
Elven bread is +3 dice to a heal check, and it comes in 6 portions.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why are you looking at me?
Because you're the only one that doesn't know.
I didn't know that.
Because you're black.
Whatever.
Oh, shit. I didn't know any of that, honestly. Cool. And at that point, I didn't have much I could do. I've seen Zig fight. I mean, what was my...
You actually haven't seen Zig fight. Nobody's seen Zig fight.
I saw him shoot a piece of bread.
I have.
Zig shot a piece of bread.
Yeah, I saw him do that.
I saw him keep his hands in his pocket in every confrontation that he's been in.
Well, but how many confrontations has he actually done anything?
One. Enough to kill a man?
One. Two. They don't know that.
Because he took Brent's heart?
Yep. He stole Brent's heart.
He stole your heart. That should be your belief. He stole my heart. Now I must serve him faithfully.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Now, hang on, Hayes. You said for Brent to take a G for his mortal wound?
Yep.
So he's a gray shade mortal wound.
He is a gray shade mortal
wound. Well, you're on the front lines now with the elven armor and gray shade.
He can still be knocked out and unconscious.
But it has to be by a good weapon.
But he cannot be killed.
I don't completely. Know that happened. My character sheet knows.
Does he feel stronger?
Zig has basically burned out all of his internal organs.
Does he feel stronger, though? Like he can take on more?
No, he doesn't.
He's just a regular
being. I was also going to vote for the broken trait. I need that, right?
Yeah. Well, I guess we'll do trait vote maybe after the next session.
Next session.
Okay. So I'll take notes on all that, because I think it's almost time for one, maybe.
It happens too fast for me.
3-4 sessions, it's time for a trait vote, you know?
Yeah, you're right.
So, because we're kind of at the end of a little bit of a leg here. So maybe at the top of the next session, I'll take some notes on everybody, and maybe we'll throw some traits around and see what sticks.
Okay. James, don't forget your scar.
Yeah, it's gonna be on the.
It
right
takes
side.
Up 3/4 of your face.
Shut up.
3/4 of your face.
Why would you agree with Brad?
Because Indiana Jones hit you in the face with a whip.
A blood whip. There was an acid blood whip, as far as you can tell.
It's still pussing.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
I have to feel
you're freaking out every the hour. Orc shaman lady, and that's pretty tough to do.
She just keeps spitting on
I don't
you.
Care.
Like, trying to watch
she
it
keeps
over.
Spitting that bile in
he
your
needs
face.
To be properly educated.
So I gained no grief off that either, immediately.
Not yet.
Okay. Oh my god, I'm so glad I found the flute too. This is just gonna be heinous with this dude. Every time I have to leave you guys, I'm gonna get a fucking grief. In the middle of combat, he's gonna be like, "Yo, Sam." Like,
"Billy, yo, Sam, take a dive. Take the hit."
Wow. It's pretty intense.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We'd know something was up after a while. I'd be like, "What is wrong with you? Stop taking a dive. What are you doing?"
I'm not taking a dive. What do you mean?
Well, I'm happy. I'm about to get paid.
Get laid.
That was good, though. I enjoyed that. And I was scared for a second. I was like, damn it. I'm going to have to do Isaac now.
Well, that was it. So I guess we will hopefully wrap this up next Friday. Well, the rest of this session.
Hopefully we'll get out of this cave.
Yeah. Hopefully we'll get out of this cave. There's not much you can do in 2 hours. Yeah, I mean, most of our sessions have run like 4 hours.
I think we did a lot there, and I didn't mean to hog it all. I didn't know all that was going to happen.
Yeah, oh, good.
That was like...
That's the die of fate.
Nope. Yeah,
that was amazing. Yeah, that was compelling, really.
And technically, I'm kind of a young orc, right?
Yeah, you're very young.
Yeah. Okay, so
yeah, me and you, they normally need a lot
me
of
me and you are in our adolescence, actually.
Yeah. You have more life paths than everybody, but you're still pretty young.
I'm in my prime.
I can,
next
I
year, I'm going down.
I can shoot no better than everybody but Zeke, who is an actually actual character. He's a fucking demon. Who gives a fuck about that?
He is an actual character. No one knows what he actually is yet.
Yeah, nobody knows.
Okay. Not even Hayes.
Alright,
man.
Can you see it? No, I can't. It's too blurry. Wait, pull it up, son.
Hold it up.
There you go.
Right there? He looks gay.
Well, he looks much cooler when you're actually like looking at the piece of paper. He looks gay as mess.
Let me see it. Let me see
that. He's like...
Or does he still look gray?
He still looks pretty good.
It's just the hair.
Yeah.
The fog.
It's just the Dragon Ball Z.
I was going to say he's a little bit and a little bit Barney the Dinosaur.
Actually, how you try to make him young.
Yeah.
All right, man. Y'all have a good night.
All right, later, Shane.
Later on, no.
All right, man.
Later, Shane.
Later.
I'm going
to have to fix that right now.